Hello everyone, I'm Don McDermott, I'm a boat builder and a sailor, and right now I'm building a 9-foot clinker-planked sailing dinghy. Now, in the last episode of this series, I took a bit of a break from the woodworking side of things to do some metalwork, because I needed to make the silicon bronze bolts which are going to hold the backbone together. So now in this episode, I get to do the exciting task of using those bolts to actually start putting together the backbone. And I'm going to start with attaching the stem and the apron together. Now, you may remember in episode 4 of the series, I made the stem and apron, that is the forward section of the boat, the curved bit that I laminated together, as I said in episode 4, which if you missed, you can watch right there. But right now, I'm going to get on with putting them together, and the first thing that I need to do is start boring the holes that will allow the bolts to go through. So you can see I'm just marking on the line that I want to follow for the bolts. This should be an inch and a half thickness, as we know. So I'm just going to mark 3/4 of an inch. That's the center point. Grab my drill. I've chosen a drill bit that is just marginally larger than the silicon bronze bolt. I have tested it and it looks pretty good. The bolt is running through, but not necessarily with complete ease, which is good because that means it'll be nice and snug in there. This is the sort of job that can be easier with two people. Because you have two different dimensions where you want to make sure that you're straight. Obviously, I want to follow this line here, but I also don't want the drill tipping away from me or towards me. Now, if I just hold the drill bit on the outside, you can see it isn't quite long enough. It's about maybe 1/2 inch of the apron that the drill has not gone through. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drill as much as I can of all the bolts along while I have this cramped up in position. And then I will take it apart, and I have these lines marked on here. And obviously I already have part of the hole drilled, so really it ought to guide the drill anyway, and it'll just finish running them through. So right now I'm just doing a bit of a dry run of putting the bolts through the holes that I've just drilled, because always good to do a dry run, because if there is anything that needs altering, any mistakes that have been made need to be fixed, it's best to find that out now before I've actually got a pot of epoxy all mixed up and ready to go.
Dinah, Is there anyone finer in the state of Carolina? If there is and you know her, show her to me. Dinah got those Dixie eyes blazing. How I love to sit and gaze into the eyes of Dinah Lee. Every night, why do I shake with fright? 'Cause my dynamite change your mind about me. Oh, Dinah, should you wander to China, I would hop an ocean liner just to be with Dinah Lee.
Dinah, is there anyone finer in the state of Carolina? If there is, then you know it, show it to me. Dinah, where the Dixie eyes blazing, I would love sitting gazing to the eyes of Dinah Lee. My Dinah, every night, why should I shake with fright? Because my Dinah might change your mind about me. Dinah.
So I've drilled the clearance holes for the silicon bronze bolts through the stern knee, all the way through the hog and the keel, and I've temporarily fixed this into place. I've put the bolts on. They are nice and tight. This is exactly how it will be. It's just I haven't glued it up yet. So I've drilled the clearance holes for the silicon bronze bolts through the stern knee, the hog, and all the way down through the keel. And I have bolted this in place, but only temporarily. They are nice and tight. This is exactly how it will be. I just haven't glued it up yet. Now, the reason why I've temporarily put this into place is I need to check how to bolt on the transom. So, basically, I'm going to put the transom into place. And the important thing here is to make sure that the transom is sitting upright. So, that, for instance, I can tell you is not upright. I mean, you can eye it to a certain extent, but I'm trying to get it really accurate. Now, what I do have is I have the center line marked onto the stern knee, and I also have a center line marked onto the transom. So, ideally, if I line those up, you would hope that that would be perfect. But in case it's not, what I have here is, I'll look closer so you can see it, that is a teak spirit level, which I made when I was at boat building college. And I'm just going to put it onto the hog and then put it not on the top of the transom because there is waste here and that's not necessarily in line. So I don't know how well you can see, but I have drawn all of the water lines on here, so I will literally just line it up with the water lines and check. Now, when I put this on the hog, I can see that the bubble is way off over this direction, but that doesn't actually bother me at the moment, because all that matters is that it is in the same place when it's sitting on the hog as it is here, because obviously where I have the sawhorses set up is not perfectly level ground. So as I say, it's just all about the relationship between the hog and the transom. So I will just give that a little check and see what we think.
1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. 9, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. Put your flat rags on. Join me, hon. We'll have some fun when the clock strikes one. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. We're gonna rock, rock, rock till broad daylight. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. When the clock strikes 2, 3, and 4, if the band slows down, we'll yell for more. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. We're gonna rock, rock, rock till broad daylight. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. When the chimes ring 5, 6, and 7,
So the process of putting the backbone together is coming along nicely. Obviously, still more work to do on that, after which I will be able to throw together the strong back, set the backbone up on that, and put the station molds in place, after which you will be able to start seeing the actual shape of the dinghy, which will be very exciting. But there is something else to mention, which is that in a few episodes' time, not sure of the exact date, I am going to be making a somewhat major announcement on my channel. It doesn't exactly have to do with this project, though related to it, and it is very much boat building, and it is very exciting, and I'm looking forward to sharing that with you all. So please do make sure that you subscribe, so that way you get notified when the next video comes out, where I carry on with putting together the backbone, and also so you don't miss that announcement, which will be coming up in, about a month's time, possibly less. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.